Hello and welcome to another video. In this video, we're going to look at the veins of the head and neck. Or to be specific, the external veins of the head and the veins of the neck that drain directly into the external and the internal jugular veins. And at the end of this video, you will find a quiz which you will hopefully be able to pass based on this video. So the venous system is divided into four systems. The first one is the veins of the heart. Then there's the veins of the vena cava superior and the veins of the vena cava inferior. And then there's the portal system. So our focus in this video is going to be up here, in the superficial veins of the head and neck, which drains into the vena cava superior. So since this is my first video of veins, I just want to inform you that usually when we talk about veins, we start from the periphery and then into the centrum, because that's how the blood flow goes. It goes from the heart to arteries and then to veins and then to back to the heart again. But when I started studying veins from the beginning, I found that it was a little harder to understand or to visualize the veins starting from the periphery and then into the centrum. So what I want to do is start from the heart towards the periphery, the same method as we used to study the arteries. And another thing I want to mention when we talk about veins is that in arteries, we have side branches. But in veins, we usually talk about tributaries, which means smaller veins which drain into larger veins. So yeah, but I will go through it throughout this video. Now, just to begin, from the heart, we have the superior vena cava, which is going to divide into the right brachiocephalic vein and the left brachiocephalic vein. Now, the brachiocephalic vein are formed by the internal jugular vein and the subclavian vein. And now, as the subclavian vein passes below the clavicle, is going to give off the external jugular vein. And here I made the external jugular vein in yellow to really separate these two veins. Now, and then the subclavian vein is going to continue as the axillary vein. But now let's look at the neck and head from this perspective in order to visualize the external and the internal jugular vein better. Now, the internal jugular vein is going to pass through the jugular foramen and then is going to drain blood from the sigmoid sinus. And the sigmoid sinus is one of the dural sinuses we have in the brain. And I'm going to try to cover the dural sinuses in my next video, but just keep in mind that the sigmoid sinus is one of the dural sinuses that drain blood from the brain. And they lie in the two layers of the dura mater. The external jugular, however, is going to divide into the posterior auricular vein and the posterior root of the retromandibular vein. Retromandibular vein. This is going to become more logical later. Now, the first vein that drains directly into the internal jugular vein is the lingual vein. The lingual vein is going to receive blood from three different veins. The first one is the deep lingual vein, and then we have the dorsal lingual vein, and then we have the sublingual vein, which drains blood from the sublingual gland. Then there's the common facial vein, which is formed by two different veins. And these are the facial vein, as you see here, and the anterior root of the retromandibular vein. Now, the anterior root of the retromandibular vein and the posterior root of the retromandibular vein are going to go together and form the retromandibular vein. When we talk about the facial vein, however, this one is going to, just like the facial artery, the facial vein is going to supply the facial region with blood. And that's mostly all the superficial structures you find in the anterior part of the face, like the eyelids, the lips, you know, the masticatory muscles, the masseter muscle, the parotid glands, and so on. That's all the structures the facial vein is going to supply. But one important tributary, one important vein that's going to drain into the facial vein is the deep facial vein. And the deep facial vein is going to go towards the infratemporal fossa, you know, between the medial and the lateral pterygoid muscles, and then form this plexus called the pterygoid plexus, which is going to supply a lot of structures in that region. If you remember the maxillary artery, all the structures the maxillary artery is going to supply, The pterygoid plexus is the kind of the venous version of the maxillary artery. The pterygoid plexus is going to supply, you know, it's going to supply the teeth, it's going to supply the mastication muscles, the parotid gland, the temporomandibular articulation, and, you know, so on, nasal cavity, etc., and the internal structures of the ear, for example. And then it's going to continue posteriorly as the maxillary vein. Now, the maxillary vein is going to connect with the retromandibular vein and form the superficial temporal vein. Now, the superficial temporal vein is going to supply the parietal and the frontal region with blood. Now, the last vein of the blood supply of the head, the superficial blood supply of the head, is the occipital vein. Now, I've put the occipital vein a little to the side as a variation because as I was making this video, I found out that different sources write that the occipital vein drains into different places. So, one source I found said that the occipital vein drains directly into the posterior auricular vein, meaning that when the posterior auricular vein and the occipital vein connect, they form the posterior root of the external jugular vein. So that's one variation of the occipital vein. Another variation is that the occipital vein can drain directly into the internal jugular vein. Now, there are a couple of other variations I found also, but just remember, this vein can vary, and along with many other veins as well. So that was all for the superficial venous supply of the head. Now let's do the venous supply of the neck. And what I want to do is mention the veins that drain directly into the internal jugular vein and the veins that drain directly into the external jugular vein. And the veins that drain directly into the internal jugular vein, we can arrange them using this mnemonic that I found on the internet. It goes like this: medical schools let confident people in. And the first two are associated with the thyroid glands. So let's go ahead and add that. So the first one is the middle thyroid vein, which drains the middle part of the thyroid gland. Then we have the superior thyroid vein, which drains the superior part of the thyroid gland. Then the L and C stand for the lingual and the common facial vein. Then P stands for the pharyngeal vein, which goes towards the pharynx and form this plexus, the pharyngeal plexus, as you see in this picture. Now the next one, I, stands for the inferior petrosal sinus. Now the inferior petrosal sinus, as I mentioned earlier when I talked about the sigmoid sinus, the inferior petrosal sinus is one of the dural sinuses that's also going to drain structures within the brain. So the inferior petrosal sinus is going to drain blood from the cavernous sinus and then directly into the internal jugular vein. And so the inferior petrosal sinus is going to drain into the internal jugular vein within the cranial cavity, so after the internal jugular vein goes through the jugular foramen. So that's that one. Another vein I found is the sternocleidomastoid vein, which drains blood from the sternocleidoid muscle and then directly into the internal jugular vein. Some sources might not even mention the sternocleidomastoid vein, and some sources might do, but keep that also in mind. Then when we talk about the external jugular vein, there are four veins that drain directly into the external jugular vein. And to do that, we use PASTs. P is for the posterior external jugular vein, which drains mostly muscles and the skin of the neck and the occipital region. Then A stands for the anterior jugular vein. The anterior jugular vein is going to go anteriorly and supply the muscles and the skin on the anterior surface of the neck. And as it ascends, it's going to communicate with the other anterior jugular vein on the other side. And that connection is called the jugular venous arch, which helps with a nice collateral blood flow in case there's any occlusion, for example. Then S stands for the suprascapular vein. And the suprascapular vein is going to go towards the scapula and supply the muscles of the scapula. Then lastly, there's the transverse cervical vein, which is going to go along the neck and supply the superficial muscles of the back and also deep muscles of the neck region. So that's it. That's all the veins I wanted to cover. Now, I made this table that covers all the veins I just went through, along with structures that they drain. Now, this is where this video gets scary. I am going to make all of these names disappear. And can you, you know, from the beginning, tell me what is the name of number one? What is the name of the vein of number two? What does number three drain and what does number four drain? If you can do that, then I've managed to help you with this topic successfully. Until next time.